Hey, we are Booster. We're on the Denver Loft Sessions right here and right now.
Thank you. Aaron Patine, live in Boulder, Colorado, and I play the keyboards.
My name's Alex Vorey. I'm from the Pacific Northwest, up in Washington State, and I play the bass guitar.
I'm Les Miller. I play trumpet. I'm from Lafayette, Colorado.
My name is Mike Lehman. I'm from Virginia Beach, Virginia originally. Been in Colorado for about 5 years now. Currently residing in Denver, and I play drums and percussion.
Before I could walk, my family had a player piano, and I figured out how to play some tunes by following along the keys while the player piano went along. And then I took piano lessons shortly thereafter, for obvious reasons.
Earliest memories would be listening to the Beatles in the car with my father. My uncle got me into playing drums, and I think I kind of wanted to play the kit before I really fully understood music.
It's been around most of my entire life. My dad was a musician. He's a drummer and a singer. And so I grew up just surrounded by piles of records all around the house.
Thank you.
I love playing drums. You know, it's definitely a big part of my life. I think any drummer would tell you that rhythm is the secret to the universe, so tapping into that is a huge life force.
When you're at Red Rocks for a hike or a concert, did you know you can do your part to keep one of Denver's favorite parks clean? Friends of Red Rocks is a large volunteer organization that cleans up the park monthly and during shows. They do their cleanup thing on the last Saturday of each month and meet in the south lot. Go online for more info. And remember, when you're at the Rocks this year, partying at Shakedown Street in the south lot, or tossing a football and bumping the bass in the north, please pick up after yourself. If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV.
This right here, I pretty much just pick up the bass and just kind of think about how I feel and pick at the strings, and something usually falls out.
It was actually one of the reasons I moved out here. I'm originally from Burlington, Vermont, and I just knew how vibrant it was. So many opportunities, so many great musicians. So I think it's awesome. There's tons of venues to play, tons of great musicians to link up with, great music. Can't say enough about it.
I think it's a lot of fun. There's a lot of places to play. There's a lot of bands. It can be tricky with mid-sized venues. It's a pretty big jump from the small free coffee house to like the Fox Theater. That leap can be tricky with few venues in between. So I really hope that with how many musicians there are and how much demand there is for music, that part of the business can really grow.
There's a lot of competition for a decent paying gig in the Front Range, but you know, that's how it is across the country and I think worldwide, frankly, struggling to get that good gig. But overall, it's a great diverse scene.
It's awesome. They are easily the best musicians I have ever been able to play with. They push me every day. These guys are absolutely amazing. I have a blast doing it.
This combination of some energetic rock fusion in with it, it really strikes my fancy and gives me a chance to do what I like to do on my horn. So these guys are kind of a launch pad for me to just have fun over the top of their solid rhythm playing.
It's fantastic. This band has really good chemistry, which is something I always look for in the people I find. People you don't have to explain what you want to too much, people that intuitively know what you want. So we don't have to work very hard to really get a groove going. It happens pretty instantaneously.
Denver music fans know how lucky we are to have the world-class concert venue Red Rocks right in our backyard. This season's concert schedule is filling up fast, so check online for when your favorite artists will be playing. Many of the same production pros that bring you the Denver Loft Sessions also produce another great show on Denver 8 TV, Red Rocks Premieres. Go online for more information and schedules for both shows, and be sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube. So whether you're enjoying your favorite music outside at the Rocks or on your couch with Denver 8 TV, we'll keep you rocking all year long. Is your main mode of transportation around town two wheels rather than four? City Council and the Mayor have made bicycling and pedestrian infrastructure a large budget priority for 2014. The Mayor's Bicycle Advisory Committee meets every month, and you can have your say about biking issues in our city at these meetings. Wheel on over to denvergov.org for more information.
Me. I'll play myself. I'm not gonna give that job away.
I have no idea. I don't have a good answer for that.
I think it's pretty obvious, Zach Galifianakis.
Well, clearly Johnny Depp. We'll be right back.
Colorado Springs-based RV Zoo and the Sugar Spun Elephant Band offer a unique take on indie rock, with swirling melodic songs sure to grab your attention like a fine wine or painting. And they're bringing this tuneful, heartfelt sound to the next Denver Loft Sessions.